What is going on, guys? My name is Lucas Erickson, and today we're going to talk about how you can create some awesome retro Instagram photos. Let's get right into it. So today is actually a bit of a special video because today we're going to be collaborating with Alf Williamson. He creates exceptional content and he'll be showing you how he creates his awesome Instagram photos. But first of all, he's going to introduce himself.
Hey, what's up, guys? Alf here. I am a filmmaker, a YouTuber, and an Instagram photographer. And I have 500 subscribers on my YouTube channel, and I have 700 followers on Instagram. I create short films, vlogs, tutorials, and filmmaking-related content overall.
So yeah, that's Alf. Now, for this tutorial, you guys are going to need a camera, a phone, a computer, food, water, air, and Lightroom. Let's go.
Over on my Instagram, I usually edit my photos with kind of like a film look to the highlights and kind of like a film look to the shadows as well. So what I do is that I start to just use the basic corrections, just fix up the white balance and warm up the image if needed, and just correct all of the exposure things. Which are very important to do before you start to edit. And I also like to upper my contrast, and I also like to upper my highlights, because we then kind of create like this sun effect, as I'm going to show you guys right now. I just take my highlights up and my shadows up or down according to what I need to do. And I also take the whites a little bit up and the blacks a bit down. So I like to have the clarity around minus 40 or 30. And maybe I dehaze it a little bit in the minus, because then we create kind of this hazy look on our photos and just smoothen out all of the highlights. And then over to the vibrancy, I like to take the vibrancy up to 14-20-ish side, and I always take the saturation down to minus 30. So there we have the basic corrections. I like to take up and down the contrast after I've done editing all of the colors and tone curves and stuff like that, because then I have more control over how the image will look, or I just have more control when I don't have a lot of contrast to start with. So the next thing I would like to do is to go down to the tone curve and just create a very slightly S curve with a little bit of fade at the end, and then we have a super dope effect already. You have smoothed out the highlights and created better contrast, and then we can go over to the red channel within the tone curve. So I like to do this because then I get kind of like a teal look to the highlights, which is kind of how a film looks, and I just really enjoy that look a lot more rather than just having a straight up S-curve contrast. So this is how the red curve looks after I've done editing. As you can see, here is the before and here is the after, and you can already see that we have kind of like a teal look in the highlights, which looks very good in my opinion. So the next thing I always do is go over to the blue channel, and then I like to just upper it a little bit in the highlights and create a point in the midtones so it doesn't go crazy. And from here I can just start to edit the highlights and get them to kind of like a teal look that I really want to emulate. And then I can go fast over to the green channel and boost the highlights here as well. There we go, that's how I usually have my greens. And I also like to just create a point down in the shadows and create kind of like a fade. And I also like to do that on the blues. So I'm gonna give you guys a before and after look. Here's the before and after, before and after. So the next thing I like to do is to just play around with the HSL to just tweak the image and create a better look in my opinion. So if you like what the content that I create, my Instagram is right here, and you can click down below in the description to just go right over to my Instagram. Hope you guys really enjoyed this video. Super dope to collaborate with Lucas Erickson. My name is Alf, and keep creating.
So yeah, that's about it for this video. Please go check out Alf's channel. He really creates great content. He also regularly gives out LUTs, presets, and water like this. Please smash that like button and subscribe for more certified epic content. Goodbye.